Mr. Speaker, another day, another broken promise by a Prime Minister who said he wanted to clean up Canadian politics. There is a well-known con man in the Prime Minister's circle. He wanted to ensure his girlfriend benefited from money destined for Aboriginal communities. The Prime Minister hired that man. He trusted him. How many other con artists does this government trust? The Honourable Leader of the Government in the House.
For this member to stand up and to talk about broken promises. I have a good friend in Timmins, Ontario, Mr. Speaker, who listened to election campaign commitments from this member, not in one election, not in two elections, but in three elections, where he made a solemn pact with the voters to stand up in this place and vote against the wasteful long gun registry. And finally, when his constituents needed him, Mr. Speaker, he exposed an act of electoral fraud, Mr. Speaker, by breaking faith with his constituents. I don't need to hear about broken promises from this individual member, Mr. Speaker.
Honourable Member for Timmins. Order, order, the Honourable Member for Timmins, James Bay. Order.
Mr. Speaker, that answer speaks to the broken moral compass of this government. In my riding, I've got kids who've got open sores on their body because of the treatment that they get on reserves. But instead of help, their misery is a jump-off point for a convicted fraudster and his gal pal to make millions. Now, this Prime Minister gave this guy an all-access pass. He had the inside scoop on cabinet shuffles. So why would anybody believe a government that would allow influence peddlers and convicted felons into their inner circle?
They're here!
The Honourable Government House Leader. Order, order.
Mr. Speaker, why would the member's constituents trust him, Mr. Speaker? This is a member, Mr. Speaker, who committed massive electoral fraud. Not once, not twice, but three times, Mr. Speaker. And let me tell you, his constituents will be convicting him in the next election.
Honourable Member,